There was another side to this legend, a controversial side, because for all the acclaim, all the adulation, there was a side to the King of Pop that we need to talk about as well. He twice faced serious allegations of child abuse, always denying he molested children. In 1995, he and his then wife, Lisa Marie Presley, sat down with Diane Sawyer and answered some very pointed questions.
Did you ever, as this young boy said you did you ever sexually engage, fondle, have sexual contact with this child or any other child?
Never, ever. I could never harm a child or anyone. It's not in my heart. It's not who I am. And it's not what I'm not even interested in that.
Why did you settle the case? And it looks to everyone as if you paid a huge amount of money.
Well, that's, most of that's
to get
folklore.
Silence.
I talked to my lawyers and I said, can you guarantee me that justice will prevail? And they said, Michael, we cannot guarantee you that a judge or a jury will do anything. And with that, I was like catatonic. I was outraged.
How much money?
Totally outraged. So what I said, I have got to do something to get out from under this nightmare. We got together again with my advisors, and they advised me, it was hands down a unanimous decision, resolve the case. This could be something that could go on for 7 years.
How much money?
So let's get it behind us.
Can you say how much?
It's not what the tabloids have printed. It's not all this crazy outlandish one. No, it's not at all. I mean, the terms of the agreement are very confidential. The idea is just isn't fair, what they put me through, because there wasn't one piece of information that says I did that.
But let me ask you
to this day, nothing. Still nothing.
Let me ask
nothing,
you.
Nothing, nothing,
nothing. Nothing. I got nothing. I guess let me ask this, and I'm trying to think how to phrase it though. Here is a man who spent an inordinate amount of time with these young boys.
That's right.
What is a 36-year-old man doing sleeping with a 12-year-old boy or a series of them?
Right. Okay, when you say boys, it's not just boys, and I've never invited just boys to come in my room. Come on, that's ridiculous.
Again, nothing ever proven. Senior law and justice correspondent Jim Avila joins us now. And you covered these trials.
Yes, and while he was acquitted in court and he avoided, of course, prosecution in the first case, the problem, of course, was that Michael Jackson was practically convicted in the court of public opinion. In fact, polls show that 72% of the population, those polled, had an unfavorable opinion of Michael Jackson after these accusations. So it did hurt him.
What about his financial situation?
It hurt him financially as well. Not only did he have to pay for these court cases, he also paid several settlements to other boys. It also hurt his reputation to the fact that some say that he was in debt as much as $400 million when he died after making so much money over time.
All right, Jim. Thank you so much.